doing a demo
of the Commodore 1541 disk drive alignment. You'll have to take the chassis out of the casing and set it on the bench, however you want to set it up with your computer. Here's the Commodore 1541 diagnostic and alignment. Disk is booted up. We have our scope ready and analog alignment disk. This is the one I've used back in the early to mid 80s when I was doing this as an authorized warranty service for Commodore in North Wales, PA. I see other methods of doing this without an analog alignment disc. Yeah, they are expensive and really hard to find now, but the reason is because they were made with a machine that precisely put the pattern, an analog pattern, on the disc. Anything else you do may be effective, but this is the way Commodore has instructed its service team to do these alignments, and I think this gets your drive perfect without a lot of going back and forth. The digital system that I've seen out there, I don't know if it works. Like I said, it's hit or miss. You might get lucky, but this is how you do the alignment correctly. All right, so we're ready to go here. We'll take our disc out of the envelope and we'll do number 5 here. All right, now it's telling us the old familiar recalibration. Put the alignment disc in. We're going to get ready to do that. And we're going to put the scope probes on pin 7 and 8 of UF3 on the short board. That's what this is. You probably never saw the long board, but if it comes up to here, that's the long board. I've only ever seen a couple of 2 or 3 of them in my travels, but this is the short board. That's the correct chip. And we have the butterfly clip on there. Two probes going to channel A and channel B of the HP 50 megahertz storage scope. Storage function isn't working real well, but I think for purposes of demo, you'll get the idea. I'm going to get this fired up. I am not going to change the alignment. I did align this drive a few months ago and it's been perfect. And I will show you how that you would change the alignment or adjust the alignment if you found that it was not in alignment. So let's go over to the scope and we'll show you that they say to add differentially at 50 millivolts per division. I'm really at 100 millivolts per division here. Insert the analog alignment disc. I like to have the spindle spinning when I clamp. You know, these clamps, some of them are, the tolerance is a little high, and when they clamp the disc, it wobbles a little bit, so I don't like that. I try to have it spinning so that when I put the clamp down and the disc engages with the spindle hub, and top piece, it seats correctly. That's kind of important, and it's much better if it does, especially when you're doing a drive alignment. So we've done all that. We're looking pretty good. Once we insert the alignment disc and clamp, now you see the pattern on the scope. They say for checking purposes, the lobes sizes must be within 30%. For alignment, adjust the stepper, you know, that you're in 15%. What that means is the amplitude, number of divisions, should be, when you look at these, I'll try to show you a little bit with the storage function of this scope, but it's not very good. But, and of course, you can change your sweep if that looks better or that looks better. Set that storage up, actually makes it look worse. There you go. So whatever you can do to get a good display on your scope. And when they say the lobe sizes, when you measure the number of divisions and the amplitude of one lobe, the next lobe should be identical. When the drive is misaligned, the one lobe will be small, large as you go across. So when you change the adjustment, that's when these lobe sizes will change. And to me, this looks definitely within 15%, probably within 5%. So we'll move on to showing you how you would adjust the alignment mechanically on this drive, but I don't want to do it with my probes connected. I don't want them to fall off. If I was going to do this, if I was working on a 1541, I would, you know, tie these cables off so that when I flip it up, everything stays on. But instead of doing that, I'm going to just take the scope off of the drive, take out the alignment disc, and we'll flip this up so you can see the what you have to do to change the alignment. Now this is the AUX drive. It's got the strobe ring. I don't know if the light is tricking it or if the camera's tricking it, but of course if you wanted to set the speed, you could, there's the speed adjustment there. You could just shine a neon light or make sure you're under fluorescent light, and when the pattern stands still, then you know your speed is perfect. I think this speed is pretty good, but we don't have the right kind of lighting here. And once again, the camera may trick that process up too. So you're going to back these screws off. There's a, you know, the traditional nail polish that will hold the screw in place, washer in place, and also be a telltale if it's been changed or adjusted. That's one screw, and this is the other one. And you back them off, you know, crack them and make sure the stepper motor can move back and forth, and snug them down so that it takes a little bit of force, but you'll grab the stepper motor here in these slots and you'll go back and forth, and that will, you'll notice the lobe sizes change on your scope. And when you get those lobe sizes equal, exactly as close as you can, then you're good to go. The other thing, I will show you, let's see, I'd have to, hey, let's hook the scope back up. I wanted to show you the hysteresis check. Actually, we don't have to have that hooked up. I'll just show you on the head. So when you do the hysteresis test, lighting's not very good for this, but you'll hit H and it'll move forward and then back to the track that has the analog. Just trying to get a better view of that. So when you come in, you're just coming back to the track with the alignment pattern from the next track inward and the next track outward. And when you do that, they're saying that the typing H will offstep the head for the hysteresis check. And when the lobes appear, check for equal lobe size, and if they're unequal, adjust and split the difference. So if it's a little different from coming in from the center or coming in from the outer portion of the disc, I haven't found that to be a problem. But I guess if it was really bad, maybe that would indicate that the drive has some mechanical issues. But I've never seen it really where I've had to do that averaging. And also, the previous screen, I think, tells you to trigger on pin 9 of UC2 or 37 of UC1 for the short board, as I mentioned before, which is what we have. I don't find it necessary to do that, or maybe I should try that, but when I did this back in the 80s with this scope that I bought from Franklin Computer when they were going out of business. I was also an employee of Franklin Computer for a while. But now this storage function isn't too good. This is all tube, this scope. And I did go in and clean the pots and reseat the tubes and make sure the sockets were good, but I don't think it's up to snuff, and I'm sure there's something out there today, but I'm just playing around with this stuff right now. I'm not gonna go out and start, you know, spending a lot of money on test gear. This does a job for me for many different things. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope it helps. And you guys take care. All right.